Hey guys, welcome back to UX Hero, the home of UX writing on YouTube. And for today's quick tip, we're going to look at three typography issues you need to be aware of as a UX writer: widows, orphans, and runts. All right guys, so I've opened up a Word document here and put in some placeholder text, and I've just put it into two columns. And you'll see the first paragraph here, I've marked the last word in red. Now I call this a runt. There doesn't seem to be a consensus as to which is an orphan, which is a widow, which is a runt. Doesn't matter what the names are. This is probably the most common that you're going to see as a UX writer, because we deal with shorter blocks of text. You're probably not dealing with pages of text like this. So a runt is a word stuck on the end of a paragraph like this. It's sat on its own line, kind of dangling on the end of this block of text here. Just looks very visually unappealing. Even more so when it's in a block of text like this, you can see how much negative space it's created here, especially compared to these paragraphs on the right hand side. When you're dealing with a block of text like this, regardless of whether it's a page of text or just a standalone block, you really want the last line of text to have at least 50%, but more like 75% of the line covered with text. You don't want a single word like this. If I scroll down, I'll show you on the second paragraph here, I've also marked these in red. I would class this as a runt as well, just because it's not even at 50%. You can see you've got this nice block of text. It's kind of ruined by this runt sat on the end here. So that's the first one, a runt. Now if we scroll down to the bottom of this first column of text here, you'll see at the last paragraph, it doesn't actually end here. This last paragraph continues into the next column, which is fine. However, it ends on the first line, and that's what we call a widow. You really don't want that. A paragraph of text starting in the first column, continuing, but then ending on the first line. Again, you can see this line of text here is just kind of sat awkwardly at the top of this column. If it was two lines of text, that's fine. And having 75% of the line covered here does not solve the issue. You really want at least two lines of text here. So this is a second issue you want to be aware of, widows. And if we scroll down, we're left with an orphan, which is the opposite of a widow. You can see here the first column of text, I've marked this one in purple. We've got a single line here which continues over into the second column, and this paragraph ends here. Again, the problem is you've got a single line of text here sat on its own. So as a UX writer, what can you do to fix these issues? I know as writers, we're typically concerned with how the content reads, but you also need to put on your designer's hat and think about how it appears on your site. You don't want widows, orphans, or runts, because they make your text look visually unappealing. So if we scroll up to the top here and just focus on the runt, I'll give you three things you can do. These three options will fix the widow, the orphan, and the runt. It's up to you which one you choose. The first thing you can do as a writer is you can add content. I can add some words to this block of text, and that will push some of this content over onto the last line, getting rid of the runt. You can also do the opposite. I can delete some words, and that'll leave some room for this runt to jump up onto the line above. You'll have a nice clean block of text. But as writers, you and I both know, you've probably spent time crafting this piece of content. You don't want to be adding or removing words if you don't have to. And that's why I suggest the third option, which is adjusting the letter spacing. So what you need to do is speak to your UI designer, tell them about this issue, and ask them to either increase or decrease the letter spacing just across the affected block of text. You don't need to change letter spacing across your website. You don't want to be changing the font size, but just adjusting the letter spacing ever so slightly will solve this problem, and it's visually indistinguishable against other blocks of text. When you increase the letter spacing across a paragraph like this, it increases the space between each letter, then each word will take up more space and it'll push some content over onto this last line. If you do the opposite, which is reduce the letter spacing, that reduces the amount of space between every letter just across this block of text. Each word will take up less space and you'll leave some room for this runt to jump up onto the line above. As I say, you only need to do it to the affected block of text. You don't need to do it to anywhere else on your website. The only exception to this rule is the orphan. If we scroll down here and look at the orphan, the problem is we've got a single line of text starting here. Adding words, removing words, and the letter spacing won't fix this problem. So what you need to do is adjust the paragraph before it. If I add words here, that will push this line of text over into the next column. If I remove words, that'll leave some room for this orphan here to jump up to the line above. The same with letter spacing. If I increase the letter spacing here, this block of text will take up more room and it'll push the orphan over into the next column. And again, if you reduce the letter spacing just across this block of text, this paragraph will take up less space and you'll leave some room for the orphan to jump up, and you'll have two lines of text there, which makes it look a lot nicer. Again, the runt is probably the most common that you're going to come across as a UX writer. However, it's nice to know how to fix all three issues if you should come across them. So it's up to you which one you choose. My personal preference is letter spacing, because then you don't need to be thinking about adding or removing words. So there you have it, guys. Three typography issues, three UI issues you need to be aware of as a UX writer, and the three things you can do to fix them. I hope that's been helpful for you, and I'll catch you in the next one.